summer vacations have started, and so all parents who are watching me, I am going to talk about what your child expects from you during the vacation time. So unfortunately, even the children won't be able to enjoy the vacation like they used to earlier. They can't go out for a holiday, they can't go to their nanny's house, they can't go and chill with their friends, they can't go out for their swimming classes, for their dance classes, and there's so much that the kids used to do during their vacation times earlier. And this is also difficult for the kids, it's not just us as adults. So even kids are going through a difficult time. So I think most of us have been creating awareness among how adults can manage their mental health and what adults are going through. But it's so important that with this vacation time, what kids are going to go through and what expectation they have from their parents. So it's very important that parents need to support their kids in terms of their mental well-being. So being mental health awareness month, it's important that parents should understand that it's not just adults, even kids can go through depression. And considering this pandemic, it is so important to understand that there are so many kids also who are going through depression and anxiety. And a lot of us actually feel that it's just the parents, it's just the adults who are going through difficult times mentally and emotionally, but even kids are. So what parents can do to ensure that the kids can enjoy their summer vacation time, what things kids can do at home so that they should literally feel that they are having their summer vacation. I mean, it's not that kids had started being at home when the lockdown had started. So they should be able to feel a difference between the lockdown that was happening before the vacation time and now when they're actually experiencing their summer vacation, but unfortunately they're at home. They should be able to feel the difference. We don't want kids feeling that, oh, it's just an extension of the lockdown. Wake up, do this, do that, online classes, go back to sleep. We don't want that monotonous routine for the kids because we have to take care of the mental well-being, emotional well-being and social well-being of the kids too. So please, please parents, make sure that you are putting out an extra effort to control your emotions. I understand it's tough being parents, but you need to control your emotions and at the same time support your kids and take care of their mental well-being too. So my request to parents is that please do not put the news channel on all the time because we don't want kids getting scared of what is happening. Of course, they can't understand what a pandemic is or what COVID-19 is, whether the vaccine is coming or not coming. I mean, there are so many questions going on in our mind. So I imagine when kids can't understand or gain a clarity on what exactly is happening right now in the world. So best is do not let the child get scared. We don't want the children getting scared that this is going to be the new normal. Will they always have to study from home online? Will they never get to play? Will they never get to meet their friends? We don't want the kids getting scared. So make sure when you're watching news, please don't have your kids around you while watching news channel because we don't want to scare away the kids. Secondly, let the child have its free time. Summer vacation here, let the child feel free. Let the child do what the child feels like doing. Please don't push your child to wake up on time because it's summer vacation. We want the child to wake up whenever the child feels like. We don't want the child to be forced to clean the room every day or clean the room on a defined time period. We don't want the child to take a bath on a specific time, have breakfast on a specific time. Let the child experience the holiday. Let the child feel that yes, it's vacation time because that's the least that we can do for the child right now. The child cannot go out for holiday, cannot go out for movie dates with friends, can't go for play dates, can't go for their swimming classes, dance classes. So we need to provide a comfort zone to the child at home rather than the child going into depression being at home. So even your child has an expectation from you during this vacation period. So parents, please make sure that you are not forcing your child as of now to do multiple things and not letting the child enjoy the freedom as the child used to enjoy during the vacation time earlier in the past. Let the home environment be such where the child should feel happy. should feel loved, should feel surrounded by affection, care, happiness, joy and positivity. I understand it's tough because as adults, you all are also going through a tough time. A lot of you might be losing out on their jobs, might be having a salary cut and so many other things that's going on in the head right now. But if we do not take care of the child's mental well-being right now, it can affect the adulthood and the future of the child in terms of the well-being. So as parents, you will have to step up and you will have to put an extra effort to take care of your child's well-being, because nobody else but you, I repeat, nobody else but you, who is responsible and who can take care of the well-being of the child. So play with the child at home. Define a time period where you will be able to spend an extra time with your child. You can have some board games, you can have some indoor activities, play some indoor games with your child. If you have more than one child, let the siblings bond with each other, let them play together, and you can actually give them some activities, some tasks to stay engaged at home. So for example, could be probably drawing, coloring, could be writing. If the child is fond of writing, let the child express what the child is going through. Maybe your child might just end up writing something interesting about his experience during this lockdown. Let's understand how a child is feeling and what a child is going through during this lockdown. So let your child feel free to write. Let your child start a journal if the child hasn't started yet. And please do not start nagging your child when every time your child wants to talk to a friend over the phone or wants to do a video call with a friend. And let the child feel free to socially stay connected with the peer, with the fellow friends, because it's important that the child should also maintain their social skills and the social life. We don't want children to feel socially disconnected because it can really affect the mental health of the child. Thirdly would be the overall physical well-being of the child. So we want the child not to gain weight, because a lot of children are already suffering from obesity, which is one of the factors why a lot of children are also developing early childhood diabetes. So to keep your child physically active at home, best way, if you have more than one child, is to give a competition sort of activity to the child, to say, okay, let's see, out of the two of you, let's see which one will finish cleaning the room first, or which one will finish probably an exercise part first, or let's see which one of you would finish preparing a sandwich first. So activities that will actually be interesting to your child, where the child feels that, okay, let me see whether I do it faster than my sister or my sister does it faster than me, would make it interesting. We can't just force a child to say, okay, come on, it's time for you to go exercise, and we sitting and using our mobile phones or using our laptops to see what's happening online, what our friends are doing, connecting with our friends, and at the same time telling our kids to go and do an exercise. That cannot happen, that doesn't happen. Your child goes through observational learning. Your child will learn what he sees. So if you as parents are spending your time on the mobile and you're expecting your child to do physical activity at home, that doesn't happen. So the best way to engage your child in a physical activity at home is by you yourself getting involved. So tell your child, okay, let's exercise together. So that makes it interesting for a child, because children want that emotional connect from the parents. And sadly, the way parents had been so busy working in the pre-lockdown phase, children were missing out on that emotional connect. Now that you're at home, your children would actually love getting the affection and the connection from you in terms of emotional support, physical support. So they would really enjoy spending time with you if it is done without nagging. So a lot of parents sometimes have this habit of constantly nagging the child by saying, you don't do this, you don't do that, you've not done this properly, or you've not done that properly, you don't listen to your parents. This is the time we really don't want the child to be listening to this at home and actually thinking in their heads that, why did this vacation period even start, or why did this lockdown even happen? So praise your child for small little things that the child is trying to do at home. Understand that even your child is trying to get adapted to the new normal. it's not easy for children. Imagine if it's not easy for us, how tough it is for children. So try to praise your child for every small little effort that the child is making, and ensure that you are letting your child feel comfortable at home. So you will have to step out and give that extra effort to your child to let your child feel happy, to let your child feel surrounded by joy, happiness, positive energy at home, and let the child understand about what can happen. It's also important for you to prepare the child, because the children are actually smart children. Kids nowadays are very smart kids. They would talk to each other and tell each other about what they hear at home, about what they listen at home when their parents are talking about COVID at home. So the best way to tell a child about what is happening is when the parents tell it. So sit down and spend time with your children where you're talking to your child. Your communication with your child should be good, because as parents, you really have to be a good friend. It's good to be parents, but it's even better to be a good friend, because this is the time when you are the only person in the house who can be the best friend to your child. So the expectation of your child from you is also that the child expects you to be a very good friend. Especially if you're having a teenager at home, an adolescent child at home, your child will have lots of expectations from you. And being at home, you're the only ones who can actually help your kids go through this period. So my request to all parents is that please try to follow all these tips, because we want the summer vacations to be actually enjoyed as summer vacation by the kids. We don't want them to get depressed at home, because this is the time where kids cannot really go and do things that they normally used to do during vacation period. So we need to create a virtual world, a different world for them, the vacation world for them at home as much as we can. Make memories with your children. Take lots of selfies with your kids, make videos with your kids, so that the child should also feel connected, happy, involved. The child should not feel neglected. If a lot of you are actually working from home, or are bloggers, or are doing online videos, are doing online classes, webinars, your child should not feel isolated and neglected at home just because you're spending more time online. So ensure that you're involving your children in small little things that you do. For example, if you're trying to do some household activity, you can always make your child sit next to you and you can keep talking to your child. Talk about old memories. Talk about the times when things used to be normal, the old normal. Share experiences of yours from your childhood, from your school time, and discuss that with your kids, so that even the kids get something new to listen to. They are also probably bored by now by listening to the same things again and again. So bring some variety into your conversation with the kids, so that even the kids can feel different, they can feel happy, and they should feel something interesting that they're listening to, rather than the same monotonous thing that's been going on from so many days. So let's together help kids around us. Let's together ensure that even the mental well-being of children is taken care of, especially by the parents, because parents are the only ones right now who can help their kids mentally, physically, emotionally, and socially at this time period, where it's not just adults but even kids who can be suffering from depression. So being Mental Health Awareness Month, I request all the parents out there to spend some extra time with the kids and to help them to cope up through this period, to get adapted to the new normal, to let the kids know that they have the maximum comfort zone at home and the parents are doing their best to love them. So love your kids, spend some extra time with them, and ensure that you let your child enjoy the summer vacation in the best possible way. Let this be the best summer vacation for your child, because this is when the child is spending the maximum time with the parents, which never happened in the old normal. So I wish you all a happy journey and a happy summer vacation to all the kids who are probably watching me. Take care.